Okay, hello everyone. So today we're gonna make some El Martinez. In my family, so it's from my grandma recipe. It's she called it Mantecao. It was, her mother was doing it, her grandmother was doing it, and I'm making it myself. So I changed the name for El Martinez for our shop, which is how my grandmother called is called. So basically, it's a beautiful short sablé biscuits flavored with lemon zest and ground cinnamon. It's delicious. So to start with, we need 2 kilos of flour. Voilà. Ah, 2 kilos. There. Then 500 grams of caster sugar. Voilà. So easy. Then some zest. Where is my zester? Not that one, it's broken. Get my zester. Then 4 lemon zest. Okay, so that's our 4 lemon zest. And then I do with vegetable oil because you can keep it for a bit longer. My grandmother do it with lard. Okay, to be honest, with the lard, it's much crunchier. It's what it should be, really. But using it vegetable oil, it does the job as well. Similar. It's nice, and you can keep it longer. So for a shop, for life shelves, you know, it's better to do it with oil. So you mix it all through like that by hands. I did clean them, huh? I didn't scratch my nose, promise. Voilà, you mix all through like that. So here it's 700 grams of vegetable oil. It goes straight in there. It doesn't look appetizing, does it? But it's very nice. You must try. Or you could do also, I tried once with clarified butter. But again, you can't keep it as long as if it will be only vegetable oil. Voilà. Then it's very sandy. Mix it very well. Voilà. It's so nice working with hands. It's like making love with your food. Ah. Yeah. Okay. So a good mix. So basically I did say wrong. You don't need 2 kilo of flour. You need 1,500 kilos of flour. 1,500 kilos flour, 500 grams of sugar, 4 lemon zest, and 700 grams of oil or lard or clarified butter. Voilà. Okay, so now we're gonna weigh them up. I have a 60 gram bowl. Well, you don't have to do that at home, huh? Really? But because it's for our shop, I do them regular. Now let's do 70. 70 is better. Voilà, so it's very lemony at this stage. You can see the lemon zest. And once they come out from the oven, we sparkle with a bit of ground cinnamon. So good combination. Okay, so now we're gonna take each bowl, bowl it slightly, make it flat, do a hole, and done. I always ask my granny, why are we making a hole? She said, oh, I don't know, my grandmother was doing it, my mother was doing it, so we don't know why, where the hole is from. Voilà. So they're all cracked, it's okay, it's beautiful. Okay, so now we're gonna cook them at 190 degrees. Ooh, bit of smoke. Dirty oven. There we go. So not too long. We're gonna check together when it's ready to come out. Okay, so now they should be ready. They've been here 20 minutes. So if you lift them up, they're very fragile. You lift them up a bit, and it's slightly colored. Slightly color. So that means it's ready. So we take them out. Oh, beautiful, they cracked. Now we're gonna put our ground cinnamon on top. They smell delicious. Oh, that smells delicious. So I have no, we need a fine sieve. So I just made one up. Ground cinnamon. On top. Oh, and that smell when the ground cinnamon hit the hot tray is just brilliant. That's a perfect smell. Voilà. So before to pick them up, we need to let them cool down because they are so fragile. That's probably the ground cinnamon. But that's all.